In Washington, D.C., ruthless, fanatic violence erupted in the halls of Congress. Three men and a woman believed to be members of the Puerto Rican nationalist gang that in November 1950 attempted the assassination of President Truman opened fire from the visitors' gallery of the House of Representatives. Five congressmen were hit. Ben F. Jensen of Iowa, Clifford Davis of Tennessee, Kenneth Roberts of Alabama, George H. Fallon of Maryland, and Albert Bentley of Michigan, who was seriously injured. Observers noted the attack came as the Inter-American Conference opened in Venezuela, and it suggested the motive may have been to arouse anti-United States feeling in Latin America through an act of apparently blind violence carefully calculated to inflame America's relations with her neighbors. Estimates of the numbers of shots fired range from 15 to 30, and each bullet hole found is a grim reminder to those who were present of the terrible surprise attack. The gang, seized by shocked bystanders as they emptied their guns, was held at police headquarters as a widespread search was launched for others who shared in the plot. To Irving Forris, Rafael Miranda, Mrs. Lolita Lebron, Andre Cordero, the gun wielders, and to their accomplices goes the evil distinction of having perpetrated a criminal outrage almost unique in America's history. Wanton violence that shocked and stirred the nation and did only harm to the cause of the Puerto Rican people.
Bullet holes can be seen in the House chamber from shots fired in 1954 by Puerto Rican nationalists.
March the 1st, 1954, and that's when the four Puerto Ricans entered the Capitol and the House gallery where I was working and began to shoot into the chamber. Five members of Congress were wounded. No one died. I was a staffer at that time in the gallery, and our position was to sit at the apex of the gallery. And we took notes and kept abreast of what was happening. At that time, we were debating a bill which is almost very much in the news today. It was called the Bracero Bill. It was a bill allowing immigrant workers from the south of our borders to come into California and Arizona and New Mexico to work the fields and harvest the fruit and things like that. And it was pretty controversial even then. And I turned around, noticed some people came in the door, which was to my left upstairs. And then I turned around and looked at them. And I figured they were just tourists like so many people. And I paid no more attention to them. For some reason or another, I've never been able to fathom this, I decided I couldn't hear very well. And I still have that problem today. And so I moved my seat further down the aisle. We had stools there so I could be almost directly above the speaker's dais so I could hear better, which was true, you could hear better. And it wasn't 10 seconds after I moved that I heard this loud popping noise, pow, pow, pow. And I turned around in my seat to my left and looked up, and I see these people are standing up with guns in their hands, and a woman was standing with them, and she had a big flag, and she was unfurling the flag, you know, waving the flag back and forth, and I ducked underneath the ledge. We had a ledge, a writing ledge, and a phone right there, and I subsequently found out I cut my hand, and I got on the phone and to intercom to our office, and I said, there's a shooting going on out here, to my boss. And everybody was scurrying and running around, and I noticed basically some people who were in the gallery, visitors, who were grappling with these people and pushing them out the door.
I was in the back benches in the corner waiting to be called to go to the various members' chairs to determine what they needed. A call came in. I was in the first chair. I got up to go, and I took about two or three steps, and I recall hearing what I thought at the time sounded like firecrackers, almost as if you lit a pack of firecrackers and threw them, fast, rapid reports. But in reality, after the third step, I got sprayed with what made me feel was sand or ash or stone, And as a young man, I had done a lot of target practice in quarries. So I was well aware of what a bullet does when it hits and glances off a stone. It sets off a spray. And it felt like the same thing. And immediately I remember thinking, by golly, these are gunshots. They're not firecrackers. So I hit the floor. And that's right behind the elevated floor of the house. And then within a matter of a few moments, the firing ceased, and there was a lot of commotion on the floor and disorganization. But because I had an early realization of what was going on, my first instinct to see whether anyone was hurt. And my best friend, as a matter of fact, who was also a page, Bill Emerson, who I'd met a year and a half before that time, but we were roommates and best friends at school. He was also in the corner when my assignment was made. Immediately I got up and I got Bill, and we both went onto the floor and we determined that they needed stretchers, and some people were wounded. So we tried to organize the pages and other people to help us out to get these conveyances. And over the process of the next half hour or so, we participated in carrying three of the members out to the ambulances. And the last member that we took out, we went to the hospital with him. It's now a famous picture in several respects. It's the picture of the year 1954 in Life magazine. And it was taken right outside the doors of the house as we're starting on down the steps of the Capitol. The fellow with his finger pointing in front is my best friend, Bill Emerson. He was a member of Congress from Missouri and a page with me. And then I'm immediately behind him on the stretcher with the glasses on there. That's me when I was 15 years old. Then another page is on the other side, Bill Goodwin from Michigan. And the three of us were involved in carrying out about three members of Congress. We did not anticipate that it would ever happen. It was, you know, a very calm place where government activity was being carried on. And it was open to the public. We didn't ever think that anyone would violate that friendliness or that openness, but they did. And I realized that that would significantly change the Congress in the future and democracy in a large way, that people now were acting in terrorist activity to accomplish something. And so I'd have to say probably was one of the early, wasn't the earliest terrorist activities in the United States by a long shot, but was certainly the earliest in my lifetime.